Welcome back everyone. So we haven't talked about the Dockerfile yet, which is also helping you to create a Docker image which you can run further and create a container. So there is one more step before we create a container is create a Dockerfile, build the Dockerfile to get the image and run that Docker image to get the container. Okay. So either you can get the Docker image from the Docker Hub or you can write one of that. So what is the Dockerfile? So there are two ways. Either we do pull push on the Docker Hub, that is fine. Docker pull MySQL, it will pull the latest MySQL image. Docker run Ubuntu, it will check if Ubuntu is locally there, otherwise it will pull the Ubuntu image and it will run that image. But you can create a Docker file and you can build that Docker file. So Docker build command is to build the Docker file and create an image out of it. Okay, so Docker build, from the Docker file it will give you the Docker image. Docker image you will run Docker run, it will create a container for you. So the two commands are there if you are writing Docker file: Docker run, sorry, Docker build and Docker run. Okay, so Docker file, we need to follow some semantics, some rules to write a Docker file. It's not a programming language which you are writing, but some particular commands you need to follow. So you're creating a Docker file which will be created as an image when you build it. So you need to have some base image. So either you can put a base image as a Ubuntu. Okay, then you start writing instructions to install Nginx or Redis or Node.js or MySQL on top of it. So these are the command. From, you need to get the base image. So you will use a from Ubuntu. So it will install the Ubuntu image and then it will start executing these commands. So run is actually to execute a command, right? Add or copy. These are the add, copy commands, working directory, current command, environment, expose a particular code from Docker container. If you are getting Docker image from Docker Hub, it's already exposing the port 80 of Nginx. But here you are writing it from the basic. So you need to expose port 80, then entry point, volume, all these commands are out there. So CMD to start a website, run command we will do to install or run particular command. Okay, so you are installing Node.js, right? So in the run command, what you will do? Command to set up the Node.js HTTP server. In the add, you will actually add the files of Node.js application from Alpine Linux. This is the base library you are using, right? So layer 3 is the base image. Then you put add command. So there is another layer created. Then you hit run command. Another layer is created. We already have seen the Docker image is actually layered on top of bootfs. There is a Ubuntu base image or any Alpine Linux or any distribution on top of it. You are installing your application. Okay, add command, run command, cmd command, work dir command, expose command, all these commands will create a layer on top of one another. Okay, so we will create a Docker file in the next video for the Node.js app or our basic development.